Que font les pays pour mettre en œuvre les objectifs de
développement durable? What do countries do to implement the Sustainable Development Goals? In order to answer these questions, we must first understand the different stages in the national and international adoption of this international agenda. First, SDGs must be part of the national political agenda, the one taken in consideration by high-level policies. This, for instance, can be exemplified by the fact that SDGs are mentioned in the speeches delivered by prime ministers, ministers, or presidents of the republic, and also the fact that this kind of high-level people attend the national high-level forums, which take place every year in the UN, a kind of review of what different countries do in order to implement SDGs. Now, the situation differs from one country to another. We see that some governments talk about SDGs all the time and have decided that they are a political priority. For instance, in Slovenia, the prime minister mentions SDGs all the time in her speeches. Conversely, in other countries, SDGs are less well taken in consideration and not considered as a political priority. The second stage in order to adopt SDGs on the national level consists in defining an institutional framework, because one of the main principles in the SDGs consists in guaranteeing consistency between the various objectives. For this, the states have often put in place institutional schemes to guarantee consistency between the various ministerial policies. For instance, take Norway. Each minister is responsible for implementing one or more SDGs, and he or she has to talk to the other ministries to check that the other ministerial policies do not prevent his or her SDG from being attained. Another solution in order to guarantee consistency in the implementation consists in ensuring that Agenda 2030 is placed under the responsibility of the Prime Minister or the President of the Republic. For instance, in Mexico, responsibility for the agenda implementation is under the responsibility of the presidential office. The third stage consists in reviewing the situation to see where each country stands regarding the SDG objectives. This is what is called gap analysis in Anglo-Saxon jargon. Now, there is an example of this assessment on the screen regarding France. In green, we see the targets for which France is on a good trend and is likely to meet the objectives set by the SDGs. In red, we have the targets for which France has a good trend, but the trend must be reinforced if we want to reach the SDGs by 2030. In red, we have those for which the trend is not going in the right direction and where an additional effort is needed in terms of policies if we hope to meet the goals. These reviews are a way to catalogue the policies and strategies contributing to SDGs so that we can identify where there are gaps, but also we can harmonize existing strategies and policies. This is item 4, you can see on the graph. Again, Slovenia is a very interesting example because Slovenia has adopted in 2017 its new national strategy for development. And during the process, it paid attention to make sure that the strategy was in line with the Sustainable Development Goals. On the screen, you see a table showing the congruence between the objectives adopted by the National Development Strategy for Slovenia and the various goals for sustainable development. One last point that should be taken in consideration for the various countries, the participation of private players and non-governmental players in the SDG implementation. Not only members of parliament, but local authorities to make sure that SDGs are well adopted on the local level, and also private players such as companies or NGOs. Regarding members of parliament, interestingly, they try to combine SDGs with the budget voting process. In many countries, they try to make sure that SDGs are being discussed during the budget vote process. For instance, Mexico tried to initiate a work to identify budget lines in the budget that match various SDGs. We see on this graph, for instance, that Mexico spends much more money for SDG 16 with regard to justice and institutions, and far less money for SDG 6 regarding access to drinkable water and sanitation. Thus, members of parliament, during the budget voting process, may judge how the budget being proposed matches or does not match SDGs. Regarding the involvement of local administrations, I would like to mention the case of Afghanistan. They benchmark the projects with the SDGs in order to select the projects from provinces requiring financial support from the state. Finally, regarding private players, companies and NGOs, countries have put in place schemes, institutional schemes, to involve them in the discussion. For instance, Mexico has created a platform with 80 companies for the implementation of SDG. In Sierra Leone, the National Committee for SDG Implementation has brought together companies and NGOs. These activities are, however, only a small part of what is being done by companies and NGOs to contribute in the attainment of SDGs.
Pour contribuer à la mise en œuvre des ODD.